Have you ever dreamt of upgrading or replacing the SSD in your Steam Deck OLED? Dream no more. It's easy to do and it should only take you about 30 minutes. For this repair, you'll need a T6 Torx driver, iFixit opening picks, a spudger, some masking tape, and some tweezers. We highly recommend using our FixMat so you stay organized throughout the repair. You'll also need your replacement SSD and a replacement SSD foil cover. See the description for links to compatible SSD cards in the iFixit store. And make sure to back up your existing data in case anything goes wrong. Before starting, turn on your Steam Deck and allow the battery to discharge below 25% to minimize potential hazards with the lithium polymer battery. As an extra precaution, Valve recommends putting your Steam Deck into battery storage mode before starting any repairs. To do this, power down your Steam Deck and then hold the volume up button and then press the power button. Once BIOS mode has started up, use the D-pad to navigate to Setup Utility and the Power menu, and then select Battery Storage Mode and select Yes. Your Steam Deck should power down. One last thing, if you have a microSD card installed, make sure to remove it before opening the Steam Deck. If you attempt to remove the back cover with it still installed, it could snap right in half. Using your Torx driver, remove the 8 screws securing the back cover. Keep a careful record of each screw's placement for a smooth reassembly process. Next, insert an opening pick at an upward angle between the back cover and the front shell near one of the triggers. If necessary, try along the top or bottom edges before sliding it toward the handle. Glide your pick along the edge of the handle to release the clip, securing it to the front shell. Reinsert your pick and slide it along the top and bottom edges until the back cover feels loose. Grip the unclipped handle and pull it away from the front shell to release the remaining clips. Go ahead and remove the back cover carefully. Using your fingers, grip the battery cable pull tab located to the left of the battery and firmly pull the battery cable straight away from the motherboard shield toward the battery to disconnect it. Start by unlocking and disconnecting the interconnect cable labeled C-R. Next, grab a pick and cut the adhesive underneath the cable, holding it down on the motherboard shield. Then use some masking tape to secure it to the battery so it stays out of the way. Then use your T6 Torx driver to remove the two screws holding the board shield in place. Check to see if the speaker cable is taped to the bottom edge of the motherboard shield. If it is, gently peel it off. You can now remove the motherboard shield. Alright, now the SSD is in the spotlight. Remove the T6 Torx screw securing it and the SSD will pop up at a shallow angle. Simply grip the end of the SSD and pull it away from its M2 board connector to remove it. The SSD is wrapped in ESD shielding and will need to transfer it to the replacement SSD if your new SSD didn't come with it. You can slide it off using a pair of tweezers, but be gentle. Alternatively, if it's stuck, carefully peel it off. You want to keep it in good condition if possible. If your replacement SSD didn't come with new shielding, slide or wrap the old shield onto the replacement SSD. Alright, let's pop the SSD back into its M2 board connector. It should fit nice and snug. Then screw it back into place. Now that you have your fancy new SSD installed, you'll need to install an operating system on it. We'll link to this procedure in the description below, or you can click the link in the top right corner. Then grab your spudger or use your fingers and slide the battery connector into its socket on the motherboard. Now you can lay the motherboard shield back over the motherboard and screw it back into place. With that secured, go ahead and lay the interconnect cable back over the motherboard shield and reconnect the ZIF cable. Grab your back cover and carefully align the long edges with the device and press down gently. The clips should snap back into place and sit well. If not, be sure it is aligned properly. Then screw in the 8 Torx screws, securing the back cover in place. Now that you have your fancy new SSD installed, you'll need to install an operating system on it. We'll link to this procedure in the description below, or you can click the link in the top right corner. All you have to do now is plug your Steam Deck into power to get it out of storage mode. That's it, you've done it.